to Enots Engineering. I'm Alan. This is part two of a four facet drill grinding jig. Last week we made the base, the locating bush and the nut, the clamping arm and the lever. This week we're making the drill bed, the depth stop, the brass thumb screw there, another brass thumb screw that will go in the clamping bar at the top here, which I've yet to make, and I've made the brackets. But I haven't shown the brackets on the video because they're quite simple. So let's go into the workshop and see how we do it. I'm just finishing off the depth stop bracket by drilling and tapping an M4. That's another piece done. We're making the depth stop rod. This is just a piece of 1/4 inch silver steel. The first thing to do is square the end up. I need to turn the end down to 4 millimeters. .156½, so I'm about a thou under, that's all. So now that needs a thread putting on the end. I fitted the M4 die in my die holder and I've tightened the grub screw up here as far as it'll go, so it's opened the die up. I'd rather have the thread tight and take some more off than find it's too loose. Slow the speed down and get in. Reverse it.
Oh, I've just removed part of the shoulder with the die.
Turn it round in the chuck. Just face this off square, then I'll measure, see how much I've got left. .25, and I want it to be 2.437. Just double check that before I get too much off. 2.436. I'll just take the sharp edge off. Now making the depth stop locking screw. So it needs to be 3/8 diameter and at the moment it's 1/2 inch. Thread this now, M4. let go, reverse. Now, because I want the thread right up to the end, you can see it's stopped about an eighth of an inch from the end. I've turned the die round and I'm hoping to be able to go back on there and go back up to the end. Going back on.
Now, this die holder is one of Hemingway's kits. And it's one of the best things I've made, I think. No worry about hitting the face with the die.
So the thread's gone right up to the end now. And that thread will go onto this clamping bracket. It goes right up to the end. This cramps that rod that we made earlier. So what I have to do now is put a knurl on the parallel part and then part it off.
This is the knurling tool I'm using. It clamps onto the part and therefore puts less pressure on the bearings in the headstock.
This shoulder here, you can see that the knurling tool's touching on the top there before the wheel's engaged on the diameter. So I'll have to take some off that diameter. And the bottom roll is just touching, so if I tighten this down, it closes the two in. You can see it started to form the knurl. Knurl's okay. So that's that bit done. While it's there, I'll just take this edge off here because it'd be quite sharp.
And now I'll face the pip off to get the face flat. I've changed the angle of the tool so I can put a small recess on the face just to make it look nice. Now I'm starting on the drill bed and I'm just facing the two ends to length. I'm using a slitting saw to cut a slot down the centre of the drill bed. You can see there the gap between the voice and the arbor that holds the slitting saw is very narrow. I've turned the head on the milling machine 21.8 degrees. I have a stop held in the table and the component's just resting against that stop. So I can mill one side of the V, turn it round, put it back up against the stop, mill the other side without changing any settings to the angle or the table. I'm feeding the tool down using my depth stop. I've turned it round now using the stop at the back here. Make sure it's onto the parallel strips. Now mill the other side.
go down to the same depth as the first side. I'm just drilling the small hole at the end of the drill bed, and this will hold a pin that centres the drill. I've placed the drill bed at 45 degrees and I'm just taking an eighth of an inch off. Now we're making the clamping screw, and I need to turn this down to an M4 thread.
Leave it at that. So now what I need to do is put a start for the thread. I'm just going to file the dome on the end, because I have to do that anyway. I have just put my die, 4mm die, in the die stock. Bring it up to the part. Turn it on slow. Wind it in. It's just cutting. It's going to hit the face. Just release the lever when it hits the face. Reverse it. Engage it again, and it'll unscrew. Redo the dome on the end of it. Blend it in with the thread.
Just clean the diameter up, ready for a knurl.
I just need to put the taper now on the face. Doesn't say what the taper is. I couldn't tell you what the angle was because it's off the scale. It's right round on the other side. Chamfer on this. Now what I need to do is put a knurl on this end. I've just fitted my knurling tool again, and I'm just giving the knurls a clean with a wire brush. Otherwise you're just crushing the swarf from the last one into the next one. There's the spanner on this. I changed this nut here. It was a big hand wheel. I'm bringing the knurling wheels together. That's better. See there, that's got a knurl on both sides, both directions. Once more, I've changed to my parting off tool. Coin here, part this off.
This week we've made the clamping screw, the thumb screw that goes in to clamp the drill depth stop.
We also machined the drill bed. I didn't show drilling the holes on the drill bed. These are just tapped M4.
And these dimples are just made by a 10mm drill. And that's so you can hold the end to lift it up or down. So next week we'll finish off making the depth stop here for holding the drills. The drills fit in this part here.
And I also fitted the pin that holds the drill on centre line. Oh well, that's it for today. Hope that was useful. Hope it's interesting. And we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.